measuring spoons, measuring cup for liquid ingredients. For the ingredients, we need 2 cloves of garlic minced, 1 whole of big onion chopped or minced, and then 1/2 teaspoon of oregano, 1/2 teaspoon of dried and ground basil, and 1 tablespoon of olive oil, 1/4 cup of red wine, and we have 2 cans of 425 grams of chopped tomatoes. Actually, we need the crushed tomatoes, but since we don't have it, so we will use the chopped tomatoes. Okay, so now let's turn on the fire and let's start cooking. I put it into medium high heat. So let's put our 1 tablespoon of olive oil. So we need this ladle. So let's wait for the oil to get hot. I forgot to tell you, we need also 500 grams of minced beef. We use Australian here. So the pot is already hot, so let's put now, let's saute our garlic. Until light brown. And it's fragrant. Then let's add the onion. Let's keep stirring until the onion is tender or soft and it's light brown. Then let's stir in the minced beef. This is 500 grams of minced beef. Brown, well brown. So let's keep and stirring it and breaking it up with a fork. No need to drain it, just add it. Stir it and mix it. And then let's put red wine. The basil and the oregano. Keep stirring. Now let's add some salt and pepper to taste. I make 5 rounds first, then I will taste it. So let's add 10 rounds more of salt and 10 rounds of pepper. Since it's already boiling, let's simmer this for 20 minutes. Let's cover the pot and simmer. Let's lower the heat or the fire. Okay, and let's wait for 20 minutes. So our timer is set to 20 minutes. Start. So guys, sometimes you have to open this and check it out. You have to stir it to avoid from burning the bottom of the sauce. And I already add 15 rounds of salt to this. You have to taste it first. Add salt according to your taste. You want it a little bit salty. So for this, for me, it's okay already. The taste is good already. So the total of 30 rounds of salt. I say rounds because I do the twisting of this, and you have to twist it 30 rounds because of this kind of salt that we have. Cover it again. So while we are preparing, while waiting for our sauce, let's prepare our other ingredients. So we have here all the ingredients. We have Parmesan cheese, cheddar cheese, mozzarella. We have lasagna cheese. So we have 250 grams packets instant lasagna cheese. So We need also 1/2 cup of grated mozzarella and 1/2 cup of grated cheddar, 1/2 cup of heavy cream or thickened or pouring cream, 1/2 cup or 125 ml. I'm using this dry ingredients in the measuring cup so I can double up. So wait. So the time is up. So let's stop our timer. Let's open our sauce. So it's here. It's boiling. I'll just stir it again. So if you want a thicker sauce, you can add 10 minutes more than this. You want a thicker sauce. Then you have to cover it. It's a little bit watery. So let's cover it and wait for another 10 minutes. So now let's continue. So we have 1/2 cup of heavy cream or thickened or pouring cream, and then we have 1/4 cup of freshly grated Parmesan cheese. So that's all the ingredients that we need for now. We still have more. So while waiting for the rest of our ingredients in our meat sauce, let's prepare 60 grams of butter, 1/3 cup of all-purpose flour, 2 cups of milk, and 1 cup of freshly grated cheddar cheese, then salt and freshly ground black pepper to taste. So we need a pot to make our sauce. Let's turn on the fire. Medium heat. So to make our cheese sauce, let's melt the butter in the pan. Just lower the fire so the butter will not be burned. Melt it gradually. Continue stirring until it's all melted. Then let's add the flour. And stir it for 1 minute. The fire should be so low. Then let's turn off the fire, and now let's remove it from the fire. Let's put it here. Then let's gradually add the milk and stir it until smooth. Keep stirring until the mixture is smooth. then let's put it back into the fire. Let's cook it with stirring constantly over medium heat until the sauce boils and thickens. And then after that, let's reduce the heat and simmer for 3 minutes. Okay, now let's put it back. Stirring and the smooth, let it boil. So while waiting for it to boil, you have to keep on stirring on it. Stir and stir it. Then let's wait. So it starts to boil now, so let's reduce the heat and continue stirring it. Reduce our fire. Long. And then let's continue stirring it for 3 minutes until the sauce thickens. Let's keep on stirring the sauce so it won't look. It won't scorch on the bottom of the pan or the pot. So, the timer's up, 3 minutes already. Let's turn off the timer. And let's turn off the fire. So, let's transfer it here. Take it out from the fire or remove from fire. Then let's add our grated cheddar cheese. There it is. Stir it. Let's add some salt. Let's just keep on stirring it until smooth while we add the cheese. So the cheese, the cheddar cheese already melted. So I have to taste it. So let's add more salt to it. A little salt, 4 grams of salt, and 5 grams of pepper. And stir it until smooth, until it is well combined. So you have to adjust the salt and pepper according to your taste. Don't make it too salty. For me, it's yummy now. So let's set aside our cheese sauce. We will use it later. Now let's preheat our oven to 180 degrees Celsius. Here, it's preheated. So now, guys, we need this baking pan or the shallow oblong waterproof dish, approximately 24 by 30 centimeter. So we have to brush it with butter or melted butter or oil. And then we have to line it with lasagna sheets and breaking them to fill any gaps. from the dish. So what I did here, so this is the lasagna sheets. So it's already prepared. Now it's ready. Our baking dish is ready with butter already and lasagna sheets. So what I did here, I'll soak the lasagna sheets in a hot water here. I soak it here until it is soft or tender a little bit. Then transfer it to the dish. So let's start lining up our lasagna sheets here. It's here. So now let's divide our sauce into three. So 1/3 of it we will put on top of the meat sauce or the lasagna sheets. And just spread it out. Like this. It's just like we are playing. Spread it. Spread it evenly. So this is our second layer. We put lasagna sheets again, and then 1/3, another 1/3 of meat on top of it, and then let's put 1/3 again of cheese sauce here on top, and continue layering until it is covered with cheese. So this is it. So let's put again another layer of lasagna sheets. So this will be our last layer. And let's put some last 1/3 of meat again. Spread it on top. Continue spreading. So this is it, and now let's put our remaining cheese sauce on top of it. Here, that's the remaining. So let's spread the sauce, the cheese sauce on top of it. Other kids doesn't like too much cheese sauce, so it's okay. Let's not make a lot of that. Continue to spread all over on top of the meat. Now let's combine mozzarella and cheddar cheese. You have to combine, mix it. Then let's sprinkle on top of it. So this is it. Let's pour the heavy cream on top and spread it all over. Now let's spread the heavy cream on top of it. Spread it all over. cover the cheese. So creamy. So this is it. It's so creamy. Now let's sprinkle some Parmesan cheese on top. So this is our lasagna. Let's bake it now. So let's see inside the oven. Let's bake it for 35 minutes. And hope you will share it with your friends and your family.